rap is about having heart. It's not about a fucking formula. It was never about that. It's about us just expressing ourselves freely. When I started trying to do all that other shit and making music for the club, making music for this, whatever, girl, that is weak. It's lame. Loser! Sorry.
Fast forward me 2023. I'm stacking lots of cheese and making money.
Hi, I'm Doechii, and this is The Breakdown.
A little bit of a backstory. I was originally working on an album before I was working on a mixtape. The distinction between an album and a mixtape to me is about limitation versus freedom. I think this could have been an album, 100%. But when you use words like album, there are certain politics and things that come with that. Whereas with a mixtape, it is just like historically known for you to have no limitations. And so that's what this project was all about, which is why I was like, let's just do a mixtape. I want to just be able to cry and scream and color and scribble all over it and not have to worry about perfection and just be able to detach myself from this idea of the perfect project. So many things changed. I literally changed in this studio. And so there's like just shedded skin all over the place. I woke up one day and I felt very ready to stop being codependent on my label. And when I say that, I mean like codependent on their opinions, codependent on their approval, codependent on their advice even. I realized that what works for everybody else doesn't work for me. And I don't think that I fit into any type of particular formula that can just be recreated a whole bunch of times. I'm forever evolving. And once I detached from codependency, I was able to be like, I don't think I want to even do an album. I don't think I'm actually even ready for that. I'm ready for a mixtape, and I'm ready to be raw, and I'm ready to tell my story my way. And I don't want any hands in the pot. And I made that call, I made that decision, but it also represented a decision that I made in myself to be dependent upon God within me. I was just fed up with doubting myself, you know? And you doubt yourself when you have convinced yourself that something outside of you is gonna get you somewhere. And that lie that I was believing for a long time was getting too heavy for me to carry. And I was like, I genuinely can't do it anymore. I don't care, I'm snatching a wig off and we're gonna do this. I have to do it now or else it ain't never gonna get done and I'm not letting nobody take my dream. Period. It's interesting because when sequencing this album, I knew, mixtape. When sequencing the mixtape, I was like, I'm going to remove all the formula of how things should be sequenced, right? Usually people are like, we need to put the hits at the top, put the bigger songs, more commercial songs at the top, give them something creative in the middle. And blah, blah, blah. I was like, I denounce all formula right now. Let's do what feels good. And let's also tell the story in order. Even the first track, the intro track, Stankapoo, the first bar is,
let's start the story backwards.
So I'm prioritizing in my sequence and in my mixing just the stages of which I went through things, when I overcame them, and then we can celebrate and be on bullshit at the end of the project. But we need to heal first. There was a point in the mixtape, it was when I was starting to write Denial is a River, and I was really afraid of how raw and honest I was being in that record. And I know that a lot of my fans really, really love that record because I made it humorous, but it actually is very, very dark. It was inspired by a journal entry that I was writing where I was like, I'm just going to bluntly say my story. I'm not gonna try to be metaphorical about it. I'm not gonna try to be like artistic about it. We're just gonna tell the story exactly how it happened in chronological order, but in a fun and humorous way. And that was one song where I was like, this is too much. I can't say all this. But then I was like, no, I need to. I was having a conversation with Jada and she was like, other people are going through these things. They need to hear somebody talk about it. They need to hear somebody say it. And you gotta be brave enough to say it. And I was like, all right, I'll say it. My nigga DL. Sorry.
Nobody's going through that. Like, just me. Catch it. But the girls who going through that, they like, yeah, me too. All five of us. So this is Jada Love. This is my engineer, and she mixed, but also in a way kind of executive produced this entire project with me and helped me sequence and organize it. She's extremely talented.
Hi, y'all.
I was here for Denial is a River, and I had already written the rap, but I was like, do I want to do like a whole musical type of script with it as well and really take it there on some like Slick Rick children's story type of vibe? And I was like, yes, I do want to do that.
She was like, follow me, I'm about to do this intro. Don't, like, just hear me out. And then did the, like, what's up, Doechii? And I was just like, ooh, yucky, are we doing that again? And it just kind of flowed into the rest of the song. But it was really, really fun to record.
Oh, wow. I've been getting some calls. People are a little bit worried about you.
Not worried.
And I know that I was kind of that outlet for you, so.
You were.
Why don't you just tell me what's been going on?
Okay.
I needed another character to walk me through this. This song is really just like people hearing how I am, the inner dialogue that I'm having with myself. Like, okay, maybe you should really unpack that. No, I'm not. This is an inner dialogue that I'm having with the voices in my head. It just seems like I'm less crazy because I do it with a funny voice.
I wasn't surprised to hear how honest she was. The only surprising factor of it was just how quickly it came about. But the contents of the song, no, were not surprising at all.
So I called the label and I was like, I am dropping a mixtape on August 30th. Do what y'all gotta do with that information. This is happening. Then they were like, okay, girl, what's the rollout? And I was like, I'm just gonna write a song a day and I'm gonna film to it and whatever comes of that is what's gonna come of that. And that's the rollout. And they were like, well, do you have the songs? And I was like, no, I'm gonna make it today. We'll see what happens. And that's literally how it went. And I dropped the mixtape and I was like, whatever I get out of this month is what I get. So I better write my ass off. And I did.
When it got signed, that was 2021.
Okay, I just feel like this is the perfect opportunity for us to just take a second and kind of unpack what's happened to you. You know, this guy cheated on you and...
Nah, fuck it. Platinum record this.
When I got signed early, I was coming into having no money to being in a completely different tax bracket and state. Then that year turned into 2 years, and then the 2 years turned into 3 years, and I'm making music, and I'm not unpacking. I've lost friends. I've lost family. I am shedding my old self. I'm used to operating out of a place of survival, and I'm not taking time to unpack it. And so when I said, fuck it, I was just like, yeah, I know, but, well, moving on. We still got other stuff to do. I'll deal with that when it all builds up inside of me and I explode. I'm just gonna wait till I explode. Really, that explode happened to be kind of my sobriety in a way. It turned into that. That was my version of like, all right, I'm gonna let everything go. I'm letting everything go. I'm getting sober. I'm not talking to nobody. I'm not talking to my label. I'm finna be in my house. I'm a paint and I'm a write and I'm not talking to anybody. That's me exploding when I exclude myself and I shut down and I get in my hermit. Yeah. I want to talk about a realization that I've had, which is I have to make music for therapy and for me. That's my formula. And to kind of tie it in a little bit, there is a formula for songs. There's a formula for radio. There's a formula for TikTok. There's a formula for all these spaces, pop, even hip hop. What noise is that out there? Sorry.
That is really...
The other studio?
That's creativity.
Is that gonna pick up?
That's creativity.
I hear it, but we're in a studio, so it feels like...
Okay.
It's like
let's tell, they're in the room. Mm. I'll be just a second.
I got it.
Go ahead.
12 seconds later.
Got to turn the music down in the studio. Damn, I was making a point and I lost it.
Formula.
Your formula.
Formula. But in me realizing that there's a formula for everything, fuck fucking hell. I had it.
Yeah, you were going, you're cooking.
I was cooking. Yeah. Wait, say the question one more time. Fuck the formula. Fuck the balance. I just have to make music for me. I just gotta make music for me, and I make my best work when I'm not thinking about a formula, and when I'm not trying to follow nothing, and when I'm not listening to nobody, and when nobody cares, and when nobody's listening, I make the hardest thing ever. And if it blows up on TikTok, it blows up, but I can't make music from that place. It distracts me. And then I'm not able to tell the truth. Sometimes those formulas that fit for pop and radio and TikTok and the internet, and you're making music for moments instead of making music for therapy, you dilute your message, you dilute your creativity, you lose something, you lose the story because you're trying not to be lyrical miracle because pop sounds like this. This is how pop sounds. La la la, la la la, it's a hit. Who gives a fuck? Nobody knows who you are, nobody cares, nobody felt anything, nobody's life changed. And I'm here to feel something. That's my intention. You feel me? You can turn on Love Island every night, but when you want to feel something, you put on Malcolm X, one of the greatest movies of all fucking time. That's what I was trying to say.
I'm glad that you said that, because I think a lot of something that I've noticed is that people will use rap or hip hop as the not feeling genre, where it's like, when I really want to make real music, I'm gonna do country or alt rock or alternative or whatever. And it's just like, from where this genre was birthed from and what it is and all the artists that are in it currently, it's like, you're just, it's not for you.
Let's go.
It's been described as like a panic attack a couple of times. It's actually a style from beatboxing inspired by Dougie Fresh. A hip hop analyst would have recognized that. And so this was my attempt at that, inspired by Dougie Fresh. And I actually have a bunch of like really cool, funny takes of me getting to this take. It was crazy, and I want to play it for you.
All right, let's go.
I get the idea, right? I get the idea right there. Mm-hmm. I do that, and then I'm like, oh shit, let me just try that again. No. We'll do one more. I did Woosah because in my head I was like, oh my god, this is gonna flow perfectly into Catfish. It's gonna be great. But then I was like, what if the beat keeps going and I keep doing like Woosah, and then I say the lyrics of Catfish, and then it comes in, and Jada was like, no, don't do that. She's like, just bring the song in. And so yeah, I did it intentionally so that it could flow into the sequence. And that's when I was like, oh, I'm building a sequence now. I think I'm starting to get it. First half of the project is very like locked into boom bap. And I was like, I'm finna rap. Y'all are gonna get it. Like hard, back to back, keep rapping. And even when I did allow some opinions to come in, because the boys on the label, they were like, nah, you gotta space it out. Don't put it all back to back. And I was like, shut up. Absol, do you know the mixtapes that this label has bred? Shut up. We're gonna rap. It's gonna be fantastic. Sit tight.
Wristwatch, drip drop, label want the TikToks. Now I'm making TikTok music. What the?
What?
They did have valid, they came in with valid points, but it was also like the sequence intention was feeling.
Yes.
And it was also narrative. These all make sense. They're not going to make sense if we put this after slide.
Yes.
Like, it's not like we're, it's, it was also like 3 days before we had to turn it in.
Right.
And it was like, we got it now. We got it. Like, this feels good.
They were like, don't give it to him like that. Just spread it. I'm giving it to him like that.
It was not a lot of time to do a lot of things. And my boy Brian Schwaller came and helped us out a lot towards the end, like the last 3 days, to help mix stuff. But it was like, you can't, they're off camera, but their two chairs were put together. She brought a comforter from her house, a pillow, a teacup Pomeranian puppy was just running around. And it was just her passed out, me mixing, turning around, waking her up, being like, hey, does this sound good? Yeah, that sounds good. Went back to sleep, next song. And it was just kind of like that for like the last 72 hours. Yeah. And then we turned it in.
I'm so tired.
It was very intense.
Crashed.
And even like having to re-record things, or like, I started my period. Like, girl, it was really stressful. And then you have Musa, Top Son. I think you should put this song there. You should put this up. Bro, I haven't slept in 2 days. The album has to be turned in 1 day. Stop talking to me right now, please. No last minute changes. He got his pick, though. He wanted Fireflies. I didn't care for Fireflies. But I was like, whatever. And I didn't want Beverly Hills either. And that was Jada's pick. And I was like, that's fine.
I was like, please put this on the record. Like, please.
I was like, no, let's just do two more rap songs. Like, we don't need this. Nobody needs this.
The certain part of your fan base, this is going to scratch that itch. I'm like, just like these songs, like Wait Girlies and Beverly Hills. I'm like, this is that genre of like me. This is me. I'm telling you, this is going to scratch an itch. I promise
yeah.
you.
Please yeah. For the fans on. Who like when I sing and they like when I get melodic, I was like, that's fine. They can live with that because I have 18 other rap songs, so I'm not tripping. I am really delighted and blessed to see people consuming the music the way that I intended for them to consume it. I love seeing how my fans are doing yoga to the project, they're journaling to it. I see them using the music over their vlogs and their journal entries and things like that, and that's the purpose of it. I just wanted to make music that puts you in a state of groundedness and makes you feel confident in your solitude, and people are really embracing it that way, and I think that that's good. Wow, it's only been a month. This is really, I feel so blessed by that. Like, sometimes I'm very hard on myself about where I am, but my project is, I feel blessed. It hasn't been that long. I need to be more patient with myself. I'm gonna say something, but I wanna say it directly to like the camera, because I feel like there's gonna be like some up and coming artist who really needs to hear this. You have to have somebody next to you that can remind you of who you are when you're doing these things, because people who've been doing it longer than you will sometimes try to convince you that you don't know what you're talking about. And if you allow those voices even a little bit to get in the way, you can doubt yourself. And doubt breeds chaos. And so still be a student. Be a student of yourself. Be a student of your craft. But at the same time, keep somebody next to you who can tell you and remind you of who you are and ground you in that. That's it. It's really important in the creative process. And there were a lot of ideas that I would have probably talked myself out of or allowed somebody else to talk me out of if Jada wasn't like, no, this is you. This is a dope idea. Move forward with it. Shut up. Stop doubting yourself and keep going. That's it.
Platinum record this, viral record that. I'm making so much money, I'm all over the net. I'm moving so fast, no time to process. And no, I'm not in a gang, but I'm always on set.